FBI reading exam said no blood, but I said send the glass anyway. I never, because forensic scientists will have to be responsible for our own examination. The gun is from his grandfather, an antique gun, but we did spot some tiny blood spatter on it. And this is the eyeglass. Do you see what I see? The blood on it? Yes? All right, so make a long story short, those blood tissue hair, DNA was conducted, that's his own. So that's of the case. And that time, luckily no email. We got 2 million letters. People keep sending. Mailman become my best friend. Dr. Lee, another 2 boxes. My secretary don't know what to do. Say, what we're going to do? I said, open up. If it's a check, we keep it. If the bill, we send it back. Of course, the crime scene today is not limited to a body anymore. Can be a whole Manhattan, can be microscopic scene, can be a macroscopic scene, a Pauling particle, but also can be your laptop, cell phone. So crime scene definition changed so much. And the crime scene, that's why it's so important. For example, this case happened in Los Angeles, and the person owns a big store, carpet, Pershing carpet store. He worked from Monday to Saturday. Sunday, downtown Los Angeles, no business. So he goes to shop, catch up with paperwork. He usually leave 10 o'clock, get home about 3-4 o'clock, have dinner with wife, 6. But that night, 6 o'clock, did not get home. 7, 8, did not get home. Wife start calling, nobody answer. By 9 o'clock, his wife went to shop. Found the light on, husband's sneaker, husband's shirt, husband's blue jean, husband's underwear, undershirt, all there, but no husband. Where is her husband? She said, what? Huh? Wrong answer. I give you a badge. All right, you say what? In the carpet too? Okay. Wrong answer. Give me my badge back. Well, I do have cases of found people in the body in the carpet, but this one it's not. So she continued walking to the office. She saw her husband falling to sleep. She made a turn, guess what? Saw a pair of legs. Socks with blood. If crime scene people experience, knows what they're doing, right away know this person took the shoes but walked in the blood, standing up. A bottle of Listerine, usually, of course, you know, we saw so many times, usually tell me information. Listerine or bleach. When she checked on him, she said, somebody whack her from the behind. Before she fell, she looked up, she saw a big American black lady, ugly looking woman with a big afro. Big afro. She fainted. By the time she wake up, she found herself lying next to her husband. She got up, went to the men's room, look at it, some blood, so clean up, use the tissue, clean up the dress. That's her key, her pocketbook. So she called the police. And waited for a while, police haven't showed up, so she put some lipstick on and combed her hair. When detectives show up, guess who they arrest? Her. So for ladies, remember, when your boyfriend or your husband die, don't put lipstick on, all right? Mess up the hair. Otherwise, you're in big trouble. All right. So she was arrested. Laboratory DNA result come back. DNA matched her husband. She was charged first degree murder because the neighbor say, oh, she always, she main fighting, always argue with the sort of thing. Have witnesses, have DNA, have scientific evidence, have lipstick. So she retained a very well-known lawyer in Los Angeles. He contacted me right away. I said, no, I'm busy. I don't take new cases anymore. I don't take new cases anymore. We are helping so-called cold cases, old cases. So they contact Dr. Baden, the former chief medical examiner in New York, and Michael took the case. 2 months later, I went to New York City police to lecture, and Michael heard it. Dr. Baden called me, said, well, you invite you and Mrs. Lee for dinner. I said, no. Police going to buy me dinner. Oh, they're going to buy stuffed chicken. Terrible. I treat you guys filet mignon. Big piece. And Michael Jordan's steakhouse. I said, why are you so generous? Oh, I haven't seen you two for so long. I said, must have a motive. No. So the steak come really nice. He ordered a bottle of wine. I said, I don't drink. I have to drive. The waiter says, sir, that's $300 a bottle. I said, I drink two glasses. My wife got to drive. And after drinking his wine and eating his steak, I said, okay, Michael, what's the deal? Can you just look at one picture? So he showed me this picture. I said, aha, very interesting. He said, what's so interesting? I said, very interesting. He ordered another bottle of wine. Now can you tell me what's so interesting? I said, very, very interesting. What's so interesting? Anybody? Huh? Yeah. What did he say? Blood. Okay, blood, fine. What's so interesting? You just want a badge, right? Okay. Huh? Okay. Anyway, the police and the medical examiner get there, they turn the body over. So it's no document of anything. They have a handprint on his back. The crime scene report, no handprint. Medical examiner protocol, no handprint. The indictment paper, no handprint, because the body was turned and washed. It's so important, this, oh, we drink so much that night. He said, where's the handprint? I said, well, more drink, let me tell you. That's the handprint. Can you see that? Absolutely, right? So Dr. Baden say, how did you see this? And I say, you guys always say, you Caucasian have big eyes, we Chinese have little eyes, so we have to focus on evidence. So that's why I see it. Now, handprint, I don't know the size, because the detective took this picture, should get the award, but unfortunately, he should put the ruler there. When he took that picture, he did not even see the handprint. He just took a picture. But that case shows us definitely it's not hers. Much too big for her. In addition, you see the blood running on top of the handprint. Shows he was in vertical position. So the DA look at us, thank you very much, drop the case. And of course, otherwise, a trial, she going to get convicted. Going to get convicted because witness going to say she always fight with the husband and that night and sort of thing. Later the case was solved because Listerine, because this. Turn out this man is not catch up the paperwork. He goes to a gay bar to pick up male prostitute. That afternoon, he picked up a black male prostitute. Wife actually gave an actual description, but nobody believed her. So you can see how important forensic evidence is. And that's why, otherwise, you're going to have a lot of injustice. Because of the time, we're going to end up here. This case is another lesson. A individual called Dwayne Deaver worked in North Carolina. Actually, 5 years ago, I was involved in a case called famous staircase case, Michael Peterson case. And husband and wife lived in that big house, and husband and wife fall down the staircase and have all those blood spatter. But the prosecution said no, and they think it's beat up. So they did the experiment, try to use a mannequin head, hit so many times, only have that little blood spatter instead of that much. Those blood spatter basically coughing. People lying there, blood come to the mouth and nose, just keep coughing. And the prosecution used a lawyer, expert, did not even get the graduate from the college, say he's a professor, and but anyway, he was convicted. Now, after so many years later, other case catch up with them. Now all those 400 some cases, it's on appeal. So you talk about how important forensic evidence, and because the time we're going to end up here, we're going to show quickly, I promised Carol to show this why a police officer was hit by a truck. On Interstate 84, we set up a roadblock, check every vehicle. Hit and run case, we usually look for blood, hair, tissue. This truck was stopped. No blood, no hair tissue was found. They just ready to wait this truck to go. I just respond to the scene. I said, wait a second. Did you see under 160? I have some clear area. We use a chemical fuming, we highlighting. Guess what I found? Shoulder patch. And of course, here, it's there, but human eyes only can see a narrow visible spectrum. That's why you need scientific knowledge and technique to enhance. This is the truck, and here we was able to compare, reverse, then the uniform, also the uniform, all those dirt, wax, we was able to link to the truck and solve the case. No witness at all. This case, we just solved the case by measure the height of the entrance. And also the opening, initial suspect. I say impossible, that's him. And of course, our report, and Brand Devin Mitchell was convicted. And DNA, of course, become very important. We can link the suspect, also exonerate the suspect. The biggest DNA case, of course, is this case. And of course, when I got to Washington, and the Washington newspaper have a big cartoon, say Dr. Lee was in White House, checked the White House carpet, look for semen dripping. Am I looking like this? No, right? And but all my Caucasian friends say, don't worry about it. If you become a cartoon character, doesn't matter good, bad, you made it, you made it. And of course, here's the DNA. Can you see that? Of course, who's DNA? I say, scientists, you can go to White House, and when this, we review the DNA result, it's Clinton's. Except number 11, 29. Number 11, of course, I know that's Dr. Lipton. That's his, Barry's, and the rest of the DNA, I don't know. Who are those persons? Huh? They're here or no? Okay. Of course, Tiger case, everybody asked me, and yes, we did review a little bit, and he have a lot of girlfriend. 8 of them, 16. Can you see all those Tiger Woods? Them recently we found she he have more girlfriend, 12 to 17. Those are mysterious girlfriend. That's all your staff. 18 to 21. That's all your staff. Of course, the Carol Henderson sisters. So Tiger Woods case and DNA, of course, link a lot of, because the time we are not going to talk anymore. This is a cold case, took about 40 years, finally solved. So we're going to end up here, see who's the lucky person, get the fingerprint tie and the DNA tie. Fingerprint tie, I have my fingerprint with a magnifying glass and my autograph on it. DNA, of course, I have the DNA. Who's birthday? Huh? Oh, no, I give, you know, whose birthday is today? Anybody? Today? Yesterday? Tomorrow? Okay, come on. Pick one. You want to give him a hand? You want which? DNA or fingerprint? Come on, make a decision. All right. Whose birthday is April 16th? Nobody? Huh? April 16th? All right. 13? Okay, 13. Go get it. Huh? 29?
Sure. It's April 11th, Henry, by the way.
April 11th? Okay, give it to you.
No, give it to somebody out there. Come on.
All right, any Russian people, anybody want it? Okay, come on.
There we go.
Hurry up.
All right. And then all right. This is, all right.
Okay.
And this
thank
is
you very
Henry.
Much. Wait a second. Wow.
Oh, crime
scene. Yeah, go to crime scene now.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. No, thank you. We have to thank Henry. I mean.
Thank you. Thank you.